Everyone, in this video, I wanted to talk about Ideogram's new feature, batch generation. So this is for people who want to create lots and lots and lots of AI designs with a spreadsheet. So this is pretty cool. I don't know if any other app does this, but you are able to go in, create a spreadsheet, and it will batch create tons of AI designs. I got a chance to play with it, so I'm going to show you how it works and why this is so cool. You can imagine why it's so cool, but this is just for their pro accounts, but I have access to it, so I'm going to show you how it works and why you might want to use this. So let's get into Ideogram right now and check out batch generation. All right, so here I am on Ideogram, ideogram.ai, and on the home page, you're going to see, if you have access to it, I think a lot of people do, it's a batch right here, new, so it's a brand new feature. I'm going to click on it, and you can see that I did one already, but here's, I'm going to read this. Batch generation, save time and create images in bulk with batch generation. Simply upload a spreadsheet with your prompts and come back to finish images, learn more. Let's see what it says, learn more. It's gonna take you to all this. So you could go here and read all of this, but I'm gonna show you, because I like showing step by step on how to do it. So let's go here. You can see I already did one. You can download their free template right here. It can be a CSV or the full template. I'm gonna do the full template right here. Actually, I'll do both so you can see what the differences are. So I'll show you the full and the simple template. And then once we're done with that template, we're gonna upload this spreadsheet, or at least I'll show you the spreadsheet that I did upload and the results for it. And then once you upload this, it will take some time until it gets to 100%. And when it's done, you can download it, and I'm gonna show you what happens when you download it. Okay, so lots to see here. Let's see the two CSV files. Okay, so first the simple one, you can see the simple template is the one I used, and you can use either, but I'm gonna make this bigger here. So in the simple template, you have the prompt that you wanna write. So you write your own prompt. These are example prompts. The visibility, do you want it private or public? The aspect ratio, there's a bunch of aspect ratios on there. I like 4:5, so that's what I'm gonna use. 1:1 is pretty good too. Magic prompt, off, on, or auto. I like to have it on auto. Depending on how you use yours, you can change that. So you have a lot of flexibility with this one. That's the simple one. The full template, let me show you that, has a lot more things. So you got the prompt again, longer prompt, visibility same, aspect ratio same, magic prompt same, but you added what model you wanna use to the seed number. If you're using the same thing and generating, wanna have it to look the same, you can put that in as well. Rendering type, negative prompt if you want to put that, style too. Remember, Ideogram has styles, and color palette. If you have one, you can put that in here. I think this is more detailed than you probably need. I didn't use that. I just used the simple one. So I'm going to show you what I did with the simple one here. So this is the simple one, and I'll show you the one that I made. So I made one just for Valentine's Day, and I'll show you how I got these. So first thing I did was vintage style t-shirt design with a black background with text, and then I added different text for each one. So you can see each prompt's just slightly different. The only thing is text. I had them all on private, all the aspect ratio 4:5, magic prompt auto on all of them. So you might be wondering, well, where did I get this text? I actually went to ChatGPT, and I'll show you that right now. So I wanted to do 12. I'm sure you can do 20, 30, however many you want. I just did 12. So I put in ChatGPT, give me 12 funny phrases that could be used for t-shirts for Valentine's Day, since that's coming up. And look at that. Gave me, I thought some of these were long, so I just said, these are great, can you make them 5 words or less? And it did that. And I copy and pasted these into that thing. So you're gonna see here, right there, roses are red, I'm broke, Cupid missed, send pizza instead, and so on. So I just, you know, Command C, Command V, some of these things in here, and that's how I got that. So once I was done with this template, CSV file, I just came in here and saved it as a CSV file. It's typical, I just changed it. So I used the basic one that it came with, the simple one, and I added more. You can add, you know, as many as you want. I just did 12, but I would try it with 20 or whatever. And then I came back, so this is on my desktop now, and I came back here and I uploaded the spreadsheet. So once you hit upload, I'm going to show you. You just pick that CSV file. You see the one that I made for Valentine's Day? Click that. I'm not going to do it because I already did. It's just going to be double. And then it put it here, and this was at zero. And it took a little while to get to 100, probably 10 minutes or so. And then it was done. And let me show you what it gave me. So I'll show you all of it. It actually came in a folder. So this is the folder right here, the job. And look at all of these. So it did four designs for each one, about four. So I'm gonna open all of these so that you can see that. I'm just gonna click on this and this, and we can see the quality of it. Now these are still small, these are still 1024 by 1024, but it gives you a good idea of like which ones you wanna use and kinda continue with it. I'm gonna open all of these and hit Command Zero. You wanna open all 44, yes. I thought there should be 48, maybe some of them only had three. But here you go. Cupid needs to have better aim. Look at these, are so cool. They have the black background. And so the Cupid one had four, like one needs better aim, needs better aim, needs better aim, needs better aim. So one, two, three, four. And then it did this one with four. One, two, three, four. And then this one, one, two, three, four. One, love hurts. One, two, three, four. Okay. And then this one, one, two, three, four. Yep, that's nice. And all very different. They're not all the same where they just change the font and the picture. Like the font, the type, typography is different and the graphics are different. So pretty cool. Love this one. Some of them have more graphics than others, but I like how they all are laid out. It knows like what a t-shirt design should look like. Look at that, that's pretty cool. And the fact that it wrote everything correctly too. So here are all of them. This could make a really good t-shirt right here. And yeah, pizza instead, look at that. Really cool. So those are all of them, all 44, and it did it in a matter of minutes. Didn't take half an hour or anything like that. It took maybe 10 minutes and stuff. So that's batch generation. Now I can do that over and over. There's like, it doesn't say there's a limit or anything on here. Maybe I need to learn more, but I did 12. I probably could do 30. We'll see how many you can do at a time. I wonder if it actually says in here how many you can do at a time, limits. Let's see if we're checking for limits. Yeah, I don't see any limits. I think you can continue to do these over and over and over again. So have fun with this. This is batch generation. It downloads it right to your thing, and it's great for idea generation too. So if you have several ideas, like you don't have to have all of those. Like it can give you ideas on how to put these together, because when you're just doing ChatGPT, it's just giving you text. It's not like putting it together, but Ideogram actually takes these words and puts it with graphics and kind of lays it out in that size, at the 4x5 size, I think is a great size for a t-shirt. A pretty amazing, a nice addition to Ideogram. It already does some really cool stuff, but now I can do it in batches. So there you go, that's batch generation with Ideogram. Ideogram is already pretty good with the text and creating things that look like t-shirt designs. Now you can do that in bulk, like a lot of them at a time. You can see I just did 44 right there in a matter of minutes. Pretty crazy. I think this will really help if you're using AI for design or idea generation or any of those things. You can do a lot at once and just type it all out and get some really cool things with the simple file, or if you want that detailed file with all of that, you can get pretty detailed in there. So Ideogram, pretty cool thing. Hopefully you enjoy it. Test it out if you have access. Thanks again for watching. If you want to see more Ideogram stuff, I have another video right here where I talked about Ideogram's canvas, which is still in beta, which is pretty cool. You can go in and change stuff on there. Watch that video if you haven't watched it already. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.